Have you ever played a cricket or blown into a wooden whistle? Well, Rick Schuman of Hartly can answer yes to that question. He also created those pieces using a centuries-old technique called woodturning.
It is a definite challenge to your skill level, and it has a lot of historical value, those are two things that I like, is working with my hands, and I'm kind of a history buff.
Schuman's process starts with a chunk of wood with the bark still attached. He strips the bark off the wood with a hatchet. Next, he shapes the wood into a more workable object, rounding off the edges, and he only uses freshly cut wood.
The green wood is softer, it cuts better. You can actually use sharper tools with green wood.
The next step in this physically demanding process is to place the wood on what's called a spring pole lathe, which was developed during medieval times. A rope is tied around the piece of wood. Rick places pressure on the foot pedal, which spins the wood, allowing him to carve and mold the wood into whatever he wants. Today, it's a rolling pin, and no power tools or electric are used.
This is more relaxing. There's no noise other than what I make with the tools I'm using and the birds that are singing out here.
Schuman built the lathe himself and has built many of his own tools to help him pursue his passion for wood turning. This box is full of his creations. He even makes what are called hobo flowers.
It's very involved. It takes a lot of focus. It takes a good deal of effort.
This nearly forgotten craft isn't all that lucrative. Still, Rick loves using his hands to create unique pieces and loves showing people what he does.
That's the fun part. And people come in and it just amazes people. The whole concept is just, I get a lot of people who say, I've never seen anything like that before. I said, well, you need to get out more.
So with the push of a pedal and the scraping of wood, Schuman completes another piece using his old yet proven method of woodworking. His simple workshop is, as he calls it, a living museum, where he toils away preserving a form of woodworking that has almost disappeared.